Hi, so today I'm going to show you how to set up your ClickUp dashboard or your new space in ClickUp to manage a social media channel. This is really good for if you have an agency or if you're hiring subcontractors and you need to sort of take it through the entire process, but it needs approval before it gets posted. So this is the sort of way that I use to make sure sort of mistakes aren't made and everything gets approved. So let's jump on now. Okay, thanks. Go to my spaces. I'm going to create a new space. I'm just going to use a test. Now, if you go to templates, there are a ton of templates in here that you can use. I haven't been through all of them, but there's quite a few, and you can go this way too. I haven't been through all of those. I'm just going to kind of quickly show you what I do for social media management, and especially if you have an entire team of content creators. I just like to keep everything in one space. So let's give it a pizza, let's give it a green. Okay, cool, let's make it private just so that it's not causing a fuss. Okay, and then this is where we get to the sort of important stuff. Now, if you get to content, when you're writing a blog post, this makes it really easy. But social media is a little bit different. So I like to have the idea bank. Now, you can have a really in-depth idea bank. You can have your own space for that or your own list for that in ClickUp. I like to put sort of stuff that I'm going to definitely do, but, you know, need a little bit of time. I'm going to put that here. And then the sort of key elements to getting a post sorted is obviously copy. So if a post goes from the idea bank into needs copy, it needs copy. And then we have needs graphic or image. So sometimes when I'm posting like links and things like that, this whole step gets skipped. You don't have to do it in this order. This is why I like this kind of status idea. I don't know why it's making everything purple, like it's a whole vibe, right? And then so we have the copy, the graphic, and then ready to post, or well, so we'll have for approval. So this will be in your process flow. Go away. In your process flow, you'll have an idea, and then you'll give it to your copywriter, you'll give it to your graphic designer, and then either your VA or yourself, or they will move it to here for approval. And then you have ready to post, where everything's been approved, it just needs to be scheduled in, and then you have scheduled. And then what I like to do on the scheduled, especially with the date, is to use the dates, but I'll show you that in a second. And then we have posted. Okay, do these colors. Oh, everything's really green. Okay, one second. Let's get those done. Let's make you an orange. Okay, cool. So what I want to make sure is all of this is fine, but the thing I want to make sure that we've got on here, oh, not this slide, is here, calendar. So we'll make sure the calendar is there. Add any more that you want to do, but the calendar is kind of really important here. Blah, 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 review space, create space. Voila, we have a space. Okay, I'm going to fill in some test ones and kind of show you how it works in a minute and like the process that you can do. And then I'll show you some automations that you can use in here as well. I've just literally thrown in ideas 1 to 10. I've put them all across here so you can see. If you put them in the board view, sometimes it can make it a little bit easier to see. Don't need to inherit that. So you've got needs copy, graphic for approval, ready to post, scheduled, posted, complete. Now the way I tend to do this is, ideas don't have sort of an assigned person, but let's say you're running an agency or you're managing subcontractors, things like that. So you'll have idea 7, your VA will take it and it needs copy. What you can do is you can set up an automation that anytime, let me see if I can do this here. So anytime you go into the needs copy, you can change the assignee and assign it. So obviously it's only me on this board. So let's go to here. So anytime it goes to needs copy, you can then assign it to your copywriter, right? And then it's the same with any other one. So anytime you want it to go. So if you go from any to, let's say, graphic, you can then change the assignee. Now, obviously, make sure you unselect that. So then you have a graphic. It gets assigned to your graphic designer or your VA or whoever.
And you can do that for every single one of these. So anytime a status, and it does it per task, not per person. So anytime the task itself moves from one space to another, it then automatically gets reassigned to somebody else. And that then stops having to tag in and having to do all this stuff. So you've got that for a start. And then that's just that in terms of automation. You want to make it show up in the schedule, then you just need to give it a date, because if you assign it with just someone and no date, it still won't show up. So the date here is the most important thing if you want to look at it in calendar view. I like to add the dates that they're going to be scheduled in, and then at a quick glance, I can see what is due to be posted, and obviously you'll get to know your colors. So this in this case will be orange, and then if you wanted to, you could change your posted color to green so that at a glance you can see whether they're posted or not. But you know, that's entirely up to you. Change the assignee so that people don't have this on their task list. So you can, when the status gets sent to posted, you can change the assignee so it no longer comes up in their task list. You can't at the moment remove the due date, but you can, like I said before, you can change the due date and set a trigger date or choose a date. So let's say we're doing June, but this then you have to go in and do this every month, which I don't recommend. So I would say choose, make it do a days after trigger date, and then make this 30 so you can deal with it next month rather than in the middle of trying to get all of your stuff posted. And then you can also have change assignee. And then, so once you've done that, you'll have something that looks a little bit like this. Now, unless I specifically click on it in the calendar, it won't necessarily show me what's available for me, but it will show you anything that has a date on it, which is why I quite like this process, because until something is ready to post or until something is, say, scheduled, let's move over here to scheduled, nothing else has a date on it, so nothing else is going to show in the calendar. So technically, nothing other than idea four is actually scheduled and ready to go. So you can go into the calendar view quickly to see what is already live, what is already scheduled in, and then the board is used for sort of the management side of things and everything else. So if you go to posted and you remove the due date, it will come off of the calendar, so you know you don't have to look at it or worry about it. I like to keep things on the calendar until the end of the month, and then at the end of the month I go through all of the posted, and you can multi-select too, and the easiest way to do this is in a list, and so when you have multiple you can actually just go doot doot and then delete them all from there, so that's easy peasy. But yeah, so that's just really a quick and easy way to set up management of a social media channel. Of course, you could have the channel name here. So I've got one of my clients or one of the things that I do, one of my projects here. And then each individual list, you can have, channels, so Instagram, Facebook, that sort of thing. And then underneath this umbrella, you can view all of the tasks.